şeyden. We are still in Anatolian archaeology. Today I'm talking about the Archaeology Museum at Middle East Technical University. I just briefly introduce our museum, what we do, then I just go to exhibitions. Our museum was founded 1969 in METU campus, actually the complex in the Faculty of Architecture. And our building consists of three parts. In the first part, the administrative office, service area, warehouse, and some small places for lectures are placed. And the other two floor are the exhibition area. Our museum has a unique property, which is we are exhibited findings from sites which is located in our campus area. So actually we exhibited our history. These sites are Yalıncak and Koçumbeli. They were excavated between 62 and 64. And near with our campus there is a Phrygian necropolis. And it's also excavated by METU staff in 1966 and 67. Then 1969 our museum was opened. First floor of the museum, we are exhibited Phrygian tumuli findings and also displaying photographs showing the stage of excavation. And so there's also information panels. Exhibition contains some bronze artifacts, jewelries, fibula, and we have also some in-situ skeletons, scattered skeletons exhibited with it is jewelry, bracelet, fibulas, and also some piece of textile. And we have also cremation pots of frigs and some piece of burnt charts. So actually we exhibited all Phrygian tumuli burial customs. And the upper level, we exhibited the findings which were found from our campus area. Koçumbeli is dated to 3rd millennium BC, early Bronze Age. And the findings consist of spindle wool, stamp seals, female figurines, animal figurines, bone and stone tools, pots. So it's indicated typical early Bronze Age villages. And the Yalıncak, we have some pitos, some rider figurines, candle. And it is dated to between the 7th century BC to today. So actually we exhibited 5,000 years of our campus area. We are small but active museum. 4,000 people is great number for us because we are just a small university museum, and we prepare some guided tours every Tuesday and Thursday. We give some museum seminars, and some departments, archaeometry, settlement archaeology, and museology departments use our museum as a workshop area. We do also some science and society project. I actually want to mention that because I do that and I like that. It is 2 days workshops. First day, students just come to METU Museum. We are talking about archaeology, environmental archaeology, bioarchaeology, geoarchaeology. And second day, they excavate, they do flotation, restoration. And we do that project every autumn and every spring. We have nearly 800 inventory artifacts and 400 study artifacts, but we can't accept our collections since the changing ancient monumental law. We can't accept new items because we are a university museum. So no material to organize a new exhibition, but we want to do something new. So we want to prepare some interactive 3D exhibition system. Actually in Turkey now there's a sector which is expertise on these 3D technologies. So we use that and prepare a 3D exhibition. Phrygian tumuli are represented in this exhibition system, but we can't add Yalıncak and Koçumbeli because they have not enough data. But we add some important sites of Anatolian archaeology. And briefly, information is represented about the history of the excavation of their importance. And you can change the tour on main screen menu, then tour started. It is also reflection on the wall, so one then more than one people can see the what happened. The first site is Göbekli Tepe. You know, it is dated to 10,000 BC, except the one of the first open-air temple of the world. And now it is on the World Heritage Permanent List. It consists of some circular structures. We just turn around these circular structures, then go into the one of them, just travel around inside of the structures, closer the T-shaped pillar and get some information about these pillar height, length, and what's carved on it. Other one is Yumuktepe. Actually, it has 33 strata, but we just represent four of them. Each strata can be visited, so it's helpful to students to see change during the times. And it is also useful for the learning of certification. Just each strata, you just turn around the village, come into the building, see what's inside of this building and get information about them. And we also animated the early Bronze Age funeral. We use the Alacahoyuk prince tombs items. We just scatter around these items, and also the jewelry wearing of that is also from Alacahoyuk tombs. So you can just enter this funerary and learn some information about these items and the funerary custom. This is Kaman Kaleyuk, dated to late Bronze Age. This level is dated to late Bronze Age. One can just go through the streets of the city, see the buildings, get information about the construction techniques, construction materials, and also go into the houses and check the inciting findings. And this is Gordian Tumulis. First of all, you see the tumuli, then inside, go inside and see the architecture of the burial chamber, then go into the chamber, see the king's coffin, some wooden tables. On these tables, bronze artifacts can be seen, and when put on the cursor on these items, information about them just appeared. And this is the Aphrodisias, is the last site of the exhibitions. It is also a World Heritage Permanent List. This site's name take his name, goddess Aphrodite. It has lots of interesting building, baths, theater, temples, palace. Each of them can be visited. So, and you can get information about it is all both construction techniques and also learn what happened inside of these buildings. And this is also, we have also some rotatable photographs in the kiosk, so the children can just examine these items in a detail. They are in the chart. So this is also, children also like that photos. So the feedback of this system is very good. Actually, most of the youngest who have a lot of computer experience like that system. They see the object in the context. So it is really helpful to understand the person-object relation during existing the space and time, actually. And it is also helpful to understand these items are not have only artistic importance. They also have the information about the past society, so we actually deal with that items. They are not just the good objects. It is helpful to understand that statement. Assessment and evaluation. Actually, it is really hard for us because they just spent a very limited time in our museum. Both the children, mostly children, come our museum because the entrance of museum is free. So schools prefer to come our museums, and the university students also come. So we have interesting range. So different age groups, limited times, and we don't know their previous experiences, previous knowledge about the archaeology. So it is really hard to understand this system is really helpful or not. To do this, we do some studies. We chose 12 schools from suburban area with the limited access are chosen. 300 students age 10 to 12 with 50 guidance teachers came to museum, and we just talking about what is archaeology, why we do that, key concept of Anatolian archaeology. It takes 30 minutes if the students just interested. Sometimes getting longer, they ask a question. Then museum tours will start by using this 3D system. We are talking about the Anatolian archaeology and chronology. And these activities also supported with some drama techniques. Before the project, we want them draw a picture about what is archaeology. And after the project, we again want the same picture. And most of the pictures nearly same. The two subjects just prefer the draw. First of all, is dinosaurs. The answer is dinosaurs. You see before and after pictures. It is not so scientific, but it's give impression about what are we doing. So it is really change dinosaurs to some aspects of archaeology. Other group is pirates. Actually, I like this bold picture because this one is indicate that we are living on the past histories, past societies, actually. And this one, try to just understand what is stratification. So we did it. As a last word, we have a web page. You can get some information about this project, our exhibition. We also want to prepare a virtual tour and at this website. Thank you for listening.